Hello, I have started to build sequential circuits that can keep state and change over time, like this one over here. To do this, they need a clock generator, which is something that transforms time into an input that's constantly changing, that is used to trigger the changes in state. This means that this circuit could be changing. And I can do that without having me to do anything. Look, no hands. The clock is off camera, connected through this wire over here, and I'll show it to you in a second. So in devices like computers, you want clocks to go as fast as possible, perhaps millions or billions of times a second, and the kind of signals needed to that can be generated using crystals like this one over here. But I won't be using that. I'm learning, so I don't want things to go that fast, because I would like to see what's going on, and myself, I'm not that fast. So what I need is a slow clock, like this one over here. So with this one, I can adjust the speed and make it go very slow or fast. Or very fast. So another useful feature is that it has an input line that can be used to post this electronically, and let me here, and I can stop it or restart it from essentially a control signal that could be triggered from a different circuit. So in this case, I don't need to stop it, so it's just put manually into ground. And if I really want to debug this, I can put this on pause, and once it's paused, I can single step it and see exactly what's going on step by step and measure. So this is not just my clock, it's my debugger. If you roam around electronics YouTube channels, you probably have seen this feature set in Benito's videos and his clock circuit. If you're not familiar, go watch his channel. He builds cool stuff and he's a brilliant educator. And he also has a clock that looks like this. This clock is explained in a series of videos and it's based on the Digital Computers Electronics book by Malvino. And this clock is also a cool demo and tutorial of the 555 timer RC. It uses three of them in kind of different configurations, and it has a few logic gates, so it's super educational. But what I wanted is the functionality of this clock, but for practical reasons, not to educate someone. And this clock is somewhat big, and it's essentially a whole breadboard with six different ICs. So I set to make something equally functional, but significantly more compact. So the trick to make this clock so compact is this chip over here. So this is an ATF16V8. This is a programmable logic device. It has a few dozen of gates and flip-flops inside, but the clever bit is that you can rewire those with an EEPROM programmer. So you need a programmer device, you cannot do it with just an Arduino. It's super useful. So I don't think explaining how this whole thing works makes for great video material. I have documented the full design and some explanation, including this tight layout, into the channel's GitHub, which you can find in the description. And if you have any comments about that design, feel free to post them in the comment section of this video. I may end up doing extra content about interesting details on this build, which would be mainly about using a programmer and programming this PLD, this programmable logic device. But that's behind the long backlog of stuff that I have in my plans, so we'll see. What you will definitely see more of is this little guy in future videos and projects. So I hope you have enjoyed this, and thank you for watching. Until the next video.